class to children. So in today's class, next class, we saw the practice 1.5. So open your textbook on page number 241. So in practice 1.5, they have given the word problems. So read the first one. Sarita has 86 rupees 50 paise in her piggy bank. Her father gave her, so her father gave her 48 rupees more. How much money does she have in the piggy bank now? So already Sarita has 86 rupees and 50 paise. So after that her father gave her 48 rupees more. So now totally how much money Sarita has? So now we have to add the 86 rupees 50 paise and 48 rupees. The first one. Sarita has 86 rupees 50 paise and her father gave her father gave 48 rupees. And we have to mention the paisa number also. So if there is no paisa, that means we have to mention the paisa number in the zeros. So Sarita has 86 rupees 50 paise and her father gave her 48 rupees more. Finish up to the second one. And now read the second one. Rahul has 276 rupees 80 paise and Raghav has 131 rupees 40 paise. So how much more money does Rahul have? First, Rahul has 276 rupees 80 paise and Raghav has 131 rupees 40 paise. So how much more money does Rahul have? What can do here? We have to subtract the Raghav's amount from the Rahul's amount. So the second one is Raghav. First write the Rahul's amount. So Rahul has rupees 276.80 paise. Then Raghav has rupees 131.40 paise. So Raghav has 131.40 paise. So subtract Raghav's amount from the Rahul's amount. Okay, so 0 minus 0, 0. 8 minus 4, 8 minus 4 is 4. Then point is here, so put a point. So don't forget to put this point. Compulsory we have to put this point. 6 minus 1, 6 minus 1 is 5. Then 7 minus 3, 7 minus 3 is 4. Then 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. Then after this, put the rupees symbol. So the answer is 145 rupees 40 paise. So Rahul has 145 rupees 40 paise more than the Raghav. So Rahul has rupees 145.40 paise more. Try that this in your classwork. Next come to the third one. And the third one is Vidu bought biscuits for 39 rupees 50 paise. So Vidu bought the biscuits for the amount of 39 rupees 50 paise and give the shopkeeper 50 rupees. How much money would he get back? So what can do here? Get back means we have to subtract the 39 rupees 50 paise from the 50 rupees. So the third one is Vidu bought first, always first you have to write the bigger amount.
Get back up.
from the shopkeeper. So write up this in your classwork. Okay, next come to the fourth one. Practice 1.5. Next company. She spent 13 rupees 75 paise on a box of crayons. How much money is left with her? So now what can we do? We have to subtract here. So the fifth one is for the total amount. Total amount is rupees 45. Oh, Sudha has a total amount of 45 rupees and she spent 30 rupees 75 paise on a box of crayons. So the cost of crayons is equal to 30 rupees. 75 paise. So subtract. 0 minus 5 is not possible. Subtract 0 minus. It is not possible to subtract 5 from the 0. So we have to borrow from the next number. So the next number is also 0. So to borrow from this number, we have to give some value for this 0. So again, to give value for the 0, to borrow 1 from this 5. And this 0 becomes 10. So after giving each 1 to be 0, then this 5 becomes 4. And now the 0 can able to borrow 1 from this 10. So after borrowing, the 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5, 10 minus 5 is 5. 10 minus 5 is 5. This 10 has already given its 1 to this 0. Then this 10 becomes 9. Then 9 minus 7. 9 minus 7 is 2. So after you put this point is there, put the point. Next 4 minus 3. So 4 minus 3 is 1. Then 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 is 3. 4 minus 1 is 4 minus 1 is 4 minus 1 is 3. So the answer is 31 rupees 25 paise. So 31 rupees 25 paise left with the Sudha. Sudha. Write down this in your class work. Next come to the sixth one. Read the sixth one. Arun paid a total of 1,950 rupees 75 paise as a tuition fee for 3 months. Find Arun's tuition fee per month. So for the 3 months, Arun paid 1,950 rupees 75 paise. So what is the fees of Arun's for the 1 month? So divide 1950 rupees 75 paise by the 3. So the sixth one is a so Arun paid. Arun paid rupees 1950 75 paise for the 3 months. For 3 months. So divide 3. So how can we divide this one? So write this number without this point and without this symbol. So the number becomes 1000. This number becomes 195075 divided by 3. So write this number without point and without this symbol. Divide this number by the 3. So what will we get? 1,95,075 rupees. So divide this by the 3. So 3, 6 are 18. Don't get confused about here. So one is smaller than 3. So we have to take 2 digits. 19. So 19 do not come in the table of 3. So we have to take the smaller number. So take 18. 3, 6 are 18. So 19 minus 18 is 1. 19 minus 18 is 1. And the next digit is 5. So bring it down. And now we have 15. So 15 comes in the table of 3 for the 5 times. 3 5s are 15. 15 minus 15 is 0. 15 minus 15 is 0. The next number is 0. So bring it down. So 0 is smaller than 3. So 0 will not come in the table of 3. So by putting 0 in a quotient, take one more digit. So take a 7. So 7 also will not come in a table of 3. So now we have to take the smaller number than a 7. So take a 6. So 3, 2 is a 6. So 7 minus 6 is a 1. 7 minus 6 is a 1. And the next digit is a 5. So bring it down. And now we have 15. So 3 5s are 15. 3 5s are 15. So 15 minus 15 is 0. So the answer is 65,025. In the amount after the two digits, point is 0. So put a point and write the symbol. So per month, Arun has only 650 rupees 25 paise. Okay, for today's class, it's enough. And the remaining.